In this video, we're going to dive into the question of whether it's a buyer's market right now or a seller's market. Stay tuned. It's Steve Dooley. Hey, Steve Dooley Realtor here today. And if you haven't already done so, please like this video, subscribe to our channel so you do not miss any future market update videos. And with that being said, let's dive into some quick statistics and then be sure to stick around to the end where I reveal the answer to the question of whether it's a buyer's or a seller's market right now. Things are definitely changing, and stay with us to the end and find out how. Okay, let's dive into the stats really quick through the month of October, starting with the average sales price. And this is in the entire Southern Arizona MLS, which is Tucson and surrounding areas. Looking at the year over year on the graph here, we are up 17.9% year over year. So we're 17.9% higher in price point than we were at this point last year. So house prices are still going up. However, if you were paying attention to the video last month and the month before, we were sitting at about 20% year over year. So that's showing a trend of it. Actually, the prices aren't decreasing per se, but they're not increasing by as much. So instead of a 20% return on your investment last month, you would have had only a 17.9% this month. But let's look at the bar or the trend really quick here. As you can see, it's steadily been increasing, you know, over the last 10 years. However, we are starting to see it level off up here at the top. Like last month, the price point was 335, and this month it's only 336. So it's only gone up by like $1,000. So it is starting to level off. And, you know, the question now remains to be, well, is it going to actually take a price drop? And that's going to depend a lot on interest rates, elections, and, you know, everything that's unforeseeable without a crystal ball. However, we're going to keep a close eye on it and keep you updated as it happens. So looking at the inventory, the number of homes for sale in the market right now, year over year, is up 28.9%, which is huge. So again, with the higher interest rates and everything that's happened with the inflation, it has caused a lot of buyers to take pause, and some are just not even qualified now due to the rates. But what that has allowed is some of the inventory to come back from the shortage that we are in. We are in such a dire shortage. Now some of the inventory is starting to come back on the market, and it's actually an advantage for qualified buyers because they actually have some houses to choose from, and they're not facing multiple offers, you know, within 24 hours of the home being listed for sale, which is kind of nice for a change. Flipping over to show you the trend on the inventory here, you can see we bottomed out back in 2021. You know, we had just about 2,000 homes for sale. It was actually a little bit less. It was like a little bit less at one point, but yeah, right around 2,000 is where it kind of bottomed out. And now you can see we're coming back up in inventory, showing us in October here at 2,600 roughly. Now, if we flip back, let's just look at 5 years back. You can see up here, you know, back in 2017, it was 6,000 homes for sale in MLS. So just to put things in perspective, it was still kind of a seller's market back then, but it was a lot more evenly matched. Yeah, we're not there yet. So we're not there yet. But the trend is definitely heading back that way as far as inventory coming up. Speaking of inventory, we're going to be taking a look at months of supply right now. Again, year over year, it's up 36.4%. So that just kind of makes sense that with more inventory coming onto the market, then you're going to have, you know, obviously homes sitting on the market for a longer period of time, especially when you have a decrease in demand, right, like we do right now. So we're sitting at about 1.5 months of inventory. And we are starting to see some houses sit on the market, you know, around 30 days. Around the 30-day mark is kind of what it is on the street on average. Even though these statistics are not going to reflect that, but that's what we're seeing in real life. So it's always good that you pay attention to these videos because, you know, statistics are one thing and numbers, but having the real experience, boots on the ground experience like I do, you definitely can see the trends out there as far as buyers having more power, more options, and more negotiating room, really. Again, looking at the trend months of inventory, you know, we were down, bottomed out again, just like the inventory itself, we were bottomed out in, you know, 2021. And it's, you know, this year it's steadily been increasing. And you can see over the last few months since like, you know, August, it's definitely taken a huge jump in the inventory. And since July, end of July, August, that's when we've really started to see a shift in the market. You know, really, really looking like a buyer's market, even though technically it's not right now. So looking at, you know, how the market's moving right now, it's this is the total closed sales, and that's down 8.3% from last year. So the market is definitely slowing down. Homes are not moving as quickly. Buyers are taking a little bit more time. They're actually going out, looking at several homes, going home, talking about it, you know, that kind of thing, and being more deliberate about their buying than they were last year, just because the market last year, the inventory was so low that they didn't really have a choice or a say in the matter. It's like house came on the market, and if you didn't put an offer in within 24 to 48 hours, house was gone and you didn't get a shot at it. So now buyers are having the opportunity to, you know, be a lot more deliberate in their decision making as far as which house to pick. And they're having tons of negotiation room as well. And as you can see here, since, you know, end of May, June, right around there, that's when the rates kind of hiked up. And that's when, you know, the number of closed sales and the big demand drop. And it really just kind of shifted and slowed everything down all the way through now. And you can see that's definitely definitely going on the downward slope there. So where that's going to bottom out and pick up, nobody has a crystal ball. However, the word on the street with our lender partners and everything is that they're thinking that the rates were going to drop, you know, right after the first of the year into the 5 to 6 range. You know, right now we're sitting at about 7, and maybe it'll go up a little bit before the end of the year. But the word is that after the first of the year, we should see a drop, and with that, we'll expect an increase in activity in the market. So this is definitely one of the key indicators to determining whether it's a buyer's or a seller's market. It's the percent of list price. And again, this stat is, you know, a month old because they don't come out till right after the end of the month. And it's showing at 100%. And I believe we're sitting on the daily stat sheet about right about 98, 99% of list price. Still indicating more of a seller's market. You know, usually we like to see 85 to 90 in that range for more of an even or a buyer's market. So that's when people are actually, you know, so if we're at 90%, that would be like, you know, 90% of the houses are getting sold, you know, under the asking value, if that makes sense. So right now, like almost all the houses are still getting sold for the asking price. Now, there's a caveat to that. So again, just looking at this stat and these statistics, we're still sitting in a high seller's market. However, based on experience and just having my finger on the market right now, what's going on out there is, yeah, people are purchasing their homes, you know, for close to asking price or right at asking price, but buyers have a ton of negotiation power. We're getting, you know, upwards of 6% in seller concessions, and the sellers are actually willing to help a lot of these home buyers buy down their rates. So they're coming in with a 7% interest rate and they're getting, you know, 6%, which comes out to like $10,000 to $15,000 sometimes in seller concessions. They're taking that money and they're, they're covering their closing costs on their loans, and B, they're actually taking that money to buy down their rate. So their rates are ending up in the 5 to 6 range. definitely saving them thousands of dollars on the purchase of their home, you know, over a 30-year period of a mortgage. So, you know, that being said, let's dive into the question of, is it a buyer's or a seller's market right now? Well, technically speaking, we're still in a seller's market. Based off the empirical data and the statistics, we're still in a seller's market. However, due to the fact that this kind of shift has happened so abruptly, it's actually behaving as more of a buyer's market. Now, we're not getting offers in much under asking. We're still getting a high percent of list price, but the buyers are definitely having a lot more power in the process, a lot more negotiation power, and a lot more say on what they get in the house, which is awesome. So to answer the question, we're still in a seller's market, technically speaking, and buyers do have a lot more power than they did last year. So compared to 2021, the market feels a lot like a buyer's market, when in reality, it's still a seller's market just due to the amount of inventory we have. And there's still a low amount of inventory relative to the amount of buyers out there. So technically still a seller's market. However, it's starting to act like a buyer's market. And that's actually a really good thing for home buyers. Now is a very good time to purchase a home despite the rates. So I probably do another video on that whole topic right there, because there's a lot more to it than rates, because we can actually buy down your rate and have the sellers pay for it. Isn't that cool? Hey, thanks for watching this video, and be sure to like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any other videos in this series. If you have any real estate related questions or would just like to speak further about buying or selling a home in Tucson, be sure to go over to stevedooley.com, visit stevedooley.com, and you can book an appointment. I'm happy to chat with you and see how we can help you out. So right now, just go ahead and watch another video in this series. And again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.